of looking at things. Understand? The positive doubt. Maybe what he is saying is right. No. Nothing is right. Two way of looking at things. If you just have that maybe, that's enough. The scientist's mind, a beginner's mind, how a scientist approaches a theory, same way, approach the beginner's mind, then so much can happen, so much of work can be done. Otherwise, you'll be just sitting and wasting your time and my time. Upanishad is a very powerful process. I request you not to miss even a single session. Next thing, for Upanishad to happen, you need to be here and now. You need to be completely here and now. Means two things. One, you can't sleep. Next, you need to be inside your boundary. Your bodies are not your homes. It is more like your hotels, your lodges. You put your luggage in that and start roaming around. That is the way you use your body. Understand? Your bodies are not your homes. You put your luggage and start going around, sightseeing. But for these 2 days, you are expected to be inside your home. You are expected to be inside your home and no sleeping. There's a small story. I always love to tell this story because I myself enjoy this story. One great preacher, man who is preaching the name of the God all over the world. Anyhow, one taxi driver and this great preacher, both of them died. Reached the Emmaus court, Lord of Death. Emmaus is doing his regular inquiry. First the taxi driver came, as usual, fast. Emmaus asked, what were you doing? I was driving taxi. Then he just saw the list of the sin and merit. Now they are computerized. Tuck, tuck, tuck. Saw the whole list and said, all right. Have the golden key, go to heaven. Then next the preacher came. Yama asked, what were you doing? What's your name? I was spreading Lord's name all over the planet Earth. He started giving his regular sermon, as usual. Memorized, usually it will be memorized. And Yama said, stop, relax. Then he saw the list of sin and merits. He said, I think you need to go to hell. The moment the preacher heard this, he started shouting, what? Just for a taxi driver you gave heaven? How dare you send me to hell? I'll sue you. Shouting. Preachers are professional shouters. That is another thing. Shouting. Yama said, relax. Here up in the heaven, we don't bother what you do. We bother the result. This taxi driver guy, even though he was driving taxi, he was so wild in his driving, people were sitting inside the taxi and outside. All of them were praying for their life. He made so many people these. He made them all believers of God. What he does is secondary. But the effect of his action, he converted many of them into believers. But you, even though you were preaching, in such a way people were sleeping. Understand, the problem is, If you sleep now, when I go there, I will have problem. May not be for your sake, at least for my sake. Don't. When I go there, I'll be given the hell's key. So at least for my sake, no sleeping. We are going to directly deal with how you are living. So now, we can't afford to sleep. Neither you can afford to sleep, nor I can afford to sleep. So both of us have to remain awake. Do something. What you will do is up to you. But we can't afford to sleep. Because there are so many things involved with the sleeping. When I go there, I'll have a problem. At least for that sake, I can't let you guys sleep. Second thing. First thing, no sleeping. Second thing, sitting inside your boundary. This is a very important thing to be understood. Just see your life early morning. When you get, early morning you don't get up, that is different. When you get out of your bed and start brushing, if at all, already your mind is sitting in the office, thinking about your boss, thinking about the answers you are supposed to give, thinking about the work. By the time you reach your office and sitting in the office, already your mind is in the beach, evening. Thinking about the beach or the weekend vacation. If you are in the beach, evening, already your mind is thinking when to go back to the home. It is cold, it is something this, that. The funny part of your mind is, when you see a beautiful scenery in the TV or advertisement, like beautiful beach or beautiful forest or a snow-covered mountain, you always feel you should be there. And if you are there, you will be in ecstasy. That is the idea you get, especially the resort advertisements. And you almost feel, if you are lying in that chair, near that swimming pool, in that beach, you will be in heaven. But when you go there itself, you don't see that experience. Why? What is happening? Why, when we see visually, it feels that we will be in ecstasy? When we go there, it is not an experience. It's not becoming an experience. First thing, the moment you are in the beach, already your mind has started thinking about when to be in the home. When you are back in the home, already your mind has started thinking about next day routine. If your body is here, one thing is sure, you are not here. Now for these next 2 days, you will not use your body as a lodge or a hotel. You will use your body as a home. Come back. Just be inside your boundary. Only then I can work with you. You and me, both of us need to sit with each other. Understand? You and me, both of us need to sit with each other. It means what? Both of us need to sit with each other. You can't be somewhere, then I can't work on you. You need to be here, only then I can work with you. You need to be inside your boundary. Your skin is supposed to be your boundary, at least till you become enlightened. After you become enlightened, how alive you feel inside your skin, the same life you will feel inside every skin. Inside this pillow, inside this seat, inside everything, you will feel that same life. At least now, skin is your boundary. That is your boundary. Come back. Come back. Be inside your skin, inside your boundary. Only then, the Upanishad can happen. Both of us need to sit with each other. That is why this Upanishad starts with a beautiful mantra. Sahana vavatu, sahanau bunaktu, sahaviryam karavavahai, tejasvi navadita mastu mavit vishavahai. Beautiful mantra. Let both of us not hate each other. Let both of us grow together. The beauty of the education in Vedic tradition is not egocentric. The master says, let both of us grow. He is not saying, let you grow, I will teach you. No. He is saying, let both of us grow. That's the truth. That is the truth. Let both of us work with each other. Let both of us not hate each other till we end the process. Let both of us feel connected at least till tomorrow evening. Understand? You may sit here like as you are attending a weekend workshop or a management course. Any attitude is okay, no problem. But decide, these 2 days you will sit sincerely with the whole process. I am not asking you to accept me as your guru and all. I am not asking. Actually, people ask me, Swami, should I accept you as a guru? I say, no. If I am your guru, this question will not raise. As long as this question is there, I am not your guru. Forget about it. Search, seek. And the people, one more thing. I always tell people, even if you accept me as a guru, there is nothing wrong learning from some other source or some other master or some other place. I always tell people, pluck flowers from all gardens and make a beautiful bouquet for yourself. Nothing is wrong. After all, I am here to enrich your life. If somebody else also is enriching, observe. What's wrong? It's not like a shop. If you come to my shop, don't go to other shop. It's not mom shop, pop shop. Or mom and pop shop. It's not a shop. If you come here, don't go there. Nothing. Enrich yourself. Wherever you can. Or whatever way you can. Just these 2 days, don't bother about this or that or with all your internal struggles and unnecessary useless questions. Just sit with a deep, receiving, receptive, prayerful mood inside your boundary. The whole process can happen. The whole process can happen. The Upanishad can start happening. Till tomorrow evening, let us not hate each other. That's all. So let us not hate each other. Let us feel connected to each other. Let us grow together. That is the beauty of Vedic masters. Enlightenment is ultimate experience, but not final. See, understand? The ultimate happening every moment is enlightenment. So every moment, an enlightened being is exploding and growing, expanding. You may think, how can enlightened person grow? Maybe the growing word is not a proper word. The ultimate experience happening every moment. It's ultimate. Enlightenment is ultimate. But it's not that it happens once and stops. It is happening continuously.